So, just to recap then, Army to help with UK mass vaccinations. And upon further reading, as is often the case with stories in the newspaper, that doesn't mean the Army are actually going to inject you. That means the Army will be there to make sure that somebody does inject you. We are living through unprecedented and unparalleled tyranny. I would not have believed, and I've got a wacky imagination, really I have, I would not have believed 6 months ago that the army in Britain would be readying to stand behind nurses with machine guns while they compulsorily vaccinated the entire population, or that a curfew might be being discussed at the head of government because of a virus which would struggle to kill my elderly gran. Let's go over the figures again. Flu has killed more people every single week this year. Every single week. Office of National Statistics, British government website. Flu has killed more people every week this year. And the number of dead in Britain, 40,000, is just about a typical flu season. It really is. That's about the number of people who die from the flu every year. At no point ever in the past, due to flu or any other disease, was I told to lock myself in my house, wear a mask, and do all this other shit. So there's something else afoot. That's my conclusion with which I am sharing with you. This is pish. The coronavirus lie is exactly that. It exists, but the lie that you need to be locked up and your government needs incredible tyrannical powers in order to combat it is bullshit. Public health does not require the government to have fascist tyrannical powers over you. I too will stand my ground, and you'll have to fucking kill me to give me that vaccine, which interestingly enough is one of my favorite stories. I'd like to take you back. It's 1976 in America. There's an outbreak of swine flu at a military base somewhere in America. I forget some of the details. One person dies, 13 people are seriously ill. The government decides to embark upon a mass vaccination program. Sound familiar? And so it gets a vaccine rushed into production. Sound familiar? And it then runs around injecting everybody with it. Well, guess what? Thousands of them get sick and many of them die. They have to stop the mass vaccination program and give compensation to the tune of hundreds of millions of dollars. Now, in this scenario that we're facing, the government has luckily for itself passed a law that says it's immune from prosecution for anything it does. Isn't that handy? I mean, if you're going to fuck shit up, you ought to pass a law first that says you can't sue me if I fuck shit up. So that's what they've done. The Public Health Regulations Act 2020 forbids anybody suing a nurse, a doctor, or any other member of the government for any decisions or actions that they take during the crisis. Isn't that handy? It's almost like they were planning to do some really bad shit that you might want to sue them for, and they knew that, and that's why they passed that law. So, here we are, standing on the brink of mass armed vaccination and curfew. And if you don't want it, you will be the new Jew, like me. I suggest you make a stand now. I hope to bring you a range of badges and clothing that will identify you as the new Jew, as a filthy Untermensch, a person who is unclean, a person who is untested, a person who is unvaccinated, a person who is unwilling to take your pish. And that'll be me. I will be the one with my hands in the air at the side of the road with the squaddies telling me to get down on the ground. I won't be the guy sitting in the car rolling up my sleeve. That won't be me. Alan McVicar, head for the hills. I assure you, the people in the north of Scotland have stockpiled ammunition and food, and they're waiting for you. I've been up there busking and spoken to people. One of the things they think that's going to happen is we're going to head for the hills, and they don't want us, and they're waiting for us. And the same is true in rural America. I have friends in America, friends in rural America, and they are doing exactly the same, stockpiling ammunition and preparing to shoot a horde of zombies which may or may not appear due to the whatever may or may not happen. A lot of people are afraid. There's a lot of fear in a lot of people, and it's making them behave and act in a way which is counterintuitive and counterproductive, actually, to their safety. Rather than allowing the government to inject you with an untested pharma goo that will most likely not work, that would be the best outcome, that it didn't work, and is quite likely to make you sick, is surely not the way to protect your health. When, as I said before, nobody is dying, the death rate is going down and down and down, and it's already killing less people than the flu, and has killed less people than the flu all year. So what the fuck? Stand by, people. Shit's gonna get weird.